Hi, I'm Pooya Parsa. I'm creator of NGS and Nitro and a core team member of Next. Today, we are going to have a first look at exciting features that are coming with Nitro version 3. Nitro is a server toolkit, essentially a framework set of utilities, features, and packages that allows you to write your framework and deployment agnostic servers using easy and powerful APIs. And once ready, it can automatically compile, bundle, and prepare your application to be deployed on any deployment provider that you want. You can learn more about Nitro from the official Nitro website. Here is an overall look of how Nitro features essentially, there are two parts. There is a runtime part, is the code and logic that goes to your server bundle that you run this in production or in development time. Runtime has several features. One of the most important ones is the API routes that you use them using a file system structure to define your server API handlers using as event handler API. This is powered by another framework called H3. You can learn more about it in the official website. It gives more features such as plugins that run on your server startup, WebSockets API that you can define your routed WebSocket handlers that are independent of the deployment provider. So we can just write simple WebSocket handlers. There is a built-in renderer layer that is used by frameworks for server-side rendering. There's a route rules engine that can match your routes and apply rules on them, like redirects or proxy or adding headers. There is a built-in storage system that is backend agnostic. You can configure it or just use the default options and use it for storing data in your server application. There is a core task runner and cron job runner, and you can use it to run some specific actions based on a timer or an action. There is a powerful built-in caching layer that you can use it to easily cache your API responses to make the server much faster. And there is a database layer that is already configured out of the box as well, and you can use it to have an embedded database in your application or configure it to use an external database. The second part of the Nitro is the Builder API. Builder is the part of the compatibility of Nitro that can actually build your application, bundle your user logic combined with the Nitro built-in logic, the features that it has, and make it ready for production deployment. When you want to deploy your Nitro application and you run a Nitro build or the framework command build, it bundles your server logic into the format using the configuration and deployment presets into an output format that is responsible for your deployment provider. It is powered by rollup, by the way. And there is a development part if you want to locally develop your application, quickly have iteration over it. You can use the development server. It provides an isolated dev server and worker and a built-in bundler, which is also powered by rollup, and we plan to replace it with Vite for even faster rebuilds, and it has the same experience of the production. Nitro has other features such as the built-in CLI that you can use it directly to develop server applications using Nitro. It has a peer render feature that can statically pre-render your routes during build for production. It has an extension kit that is under progress for Nitro version 3 that allows to even have more integrations to the core of Nitro without extending its core. Probably one of the main things that we was working on for Nitro version 3 and H3 version 2 releases was the web standards compatibility. Since beginning, Nitro had web standards compatibility in mind, and it was designed to make your applications to be deployable on edge platforms such as Google for Workers. But during the time, a few years ago, Node.js standard and Node.js servers was the dominant in basically all ecosystem. So instead of just trying to break everything, we tried to add a super powerful compatibility layer on top of the Node.js APIs and make sure that as much as possible, we can have MPM compatibility existing libraries, make them compatible for deployment on edge platforms. Web standards are so much powerful, and they are now getting more and more adopted. So we almost made two full rewrites of two major frameworks and two major parts of our ecosystem that make it possible that we have web standards as first-class support, yet still have Node.js, full Node.js support and performances. Here is how a traditional Node.js server application looks like if you want to create a Node.js HTTP server. You have to define a request handler, which has two parts. When a HTTP request comes, Node.js gives you two objects, an incoming message and a server response. Inside this handler, you have to read any request information that you need from the request object, make some decisions, write some logic, and using REST object, you have to prepare response, for example, set the response header, set the response and status code, and send the response body. It is all up to you, and it's simple and classic. Also, frameworks such as Express that are built on top of the Node.js Server API have the same characteristics. With new runtimes such as Dino, Bun, and Coffee Workers, they adopted something new, something that was based on new web standards, request and response objects. They are used also for Fetch API, and it makes the server definition simpler and different. In this new API, you only get a request object which contains the incoming HTTP request information in a different format. And inside the server handler, we have to prepare a response and return a new response instance instead of calling some functions on top of it. This format is simpler and used by newer runtimes. If you have a closer look at the differences of these two different handler formats, you can see there are two arguments. There's one argument. In Node.js, we have to handle everything ourselves. In web handlers, we have to return explicit and response object. And this new format has some major benefits that was worse for our ecosystem to migrate. First is the composability. Because the web handler format is explicit with the request as argument and the response as the return value of the function, we can easily compose this web handler as a function with other functions. We can add wrappers on top of it for interception. We can compose it to create a middleware for, system and other stuff. We can also compose it with other frameworks for compatibility because it's all explicit. It's also more observable. From a view of a runtime, what is handling and running inside this function is obscure. Runtime doesn't know if a request handler is async or sync. Runtime doesn't know if a request handler would probably throw an async error. For example, if you want to try to make an external call inside this handler. While in the newer format, because runtimes have to run the function and wait for a return value, they can explicitly observe it. They can explicitly handle errors within this function. And same for Nitro, we can do more better. This API is also more consistent. Why? Because if we want to make an HTTP call from a web browser or anywhere that supports Fetch API, you have to exactly create a request object using Fetch, and the return value of the Fetch is a response. And they are exactly the same interfaces that we have in our server side. So for a full stack framework such as Nitro, it's making everything much more understandable because the same request object is on the server and the client. Same response object that return on the server is also expected on the client. There are not much differences. And testability. Traditionally, if you want to test the Node.js handler, we have two ways. We have to either start actually a Node.js server on a port during the testing time, send HTTP requests to it and wait for responses to test them. Or we could just mock these two different interfaces using another library. This is also what we used to use for Nitro as compatibility layer for Node by polyfilling and mocking the request and response. But with this new web handler format, things are much easier. Why? Because we can quickly and easily construct the request object, call the function, and test the response behavior. It makes testing also much faster and easier and more straightforward. HTTP 2 is also being released and shipped alongside with Nitro version 3. You can learn more about issue and latest updates from the official documentation. Issue V2 is 60%, it's even smaller than bundle size. It's 10 times faster for handling web responses, and probably these two measures are making H3 one of the fastest and smallest web frameworks on the web for modern web standards. And these are with no compromises. We have these benefits regardless of the runtime and regardless of how the complex routes are. It's possible with a complete rewrite of H3. Of course, we made sure that we have as much as possible backward compatibility, and there is a true migration guide inside the official documentation that you can follow if you're already using H3. H3 version 2 is fully based on web standards, yet it has first-class support for node standards. In order to create an H3 V2, we rewrote the whole router and route matching library, a new library called RouteTree. It's also probably one of the smallest and fastest in all condition routers in the industry. H3 V2 has easier request body handling and more standard and more stable because it's based on the web standards. And we also have standard headers and URL right inside the event object. So accessing them and working with them is much more easier and familiar. In Nitro version 3, we tried to, instead of breaking behavior, focus on breaking changes that was required to make the core simpler, keep it simpler, more stable. So the bundle output size is much smaller now. We have more stability because we focused on the stability instead of introducing more features. The legacy polyfix that was previously required for fetch in Node.js less than 18 are now completely removed from the server bundle, which also makes it significantly smaller. We removed a feature called appconfig from the Nitro core because it was causing duplicate bundle size when combined with higher level frameworks such as Nux. So we removed this non-essential feature of Nitro. Internals such as legacy externals tracking system and plugin is removed to make the core also more maintainable and smaller. Nitro MPM package, it used to be Nitro pack, and thanks to Yujesh Germandi and Daniel Rowe, now we have a much shorter MPM package. And using a mirroring system, we are going to use the new shorter version of Nitro as main package for Nitro version 3. And we mirror to the other package namespace. So if you are depending on Nitro pack, you can keep using it, and you can also migrate to the new shorter one. In this new version of Nitro, version 3, we are now trying to experiment to see how much we can leverage from Nitro and from Vite integration. Initially for Nitro, when we made Nitro for Nux 3 was using Vite, and we used Nitro for server builder part, and it was powered by rollup and it's kind of fast. But as more and more ecosystem is adopting Vite, and thanks to the new multi-environment API, we can now leverage more. So one of the first things that we are thinking about is creating a Vite plugin for Nitro. And you can use this Vite plugin to quickly integrate Nitro to your existing Vite setups without having major changes to your applications, and yet still leverage all of these features. We are also experimenting with Vite as an alternative builder for rollup. All the internal buildings happen. So we refactor rollup as a separate part in the code base. We prepared the code base to support Vite as first class. We are thinking to leverage Vite environment API to make it possible to create full stack applications just with a Nitro setup. We are also trying to push Vite dev server to leverage the web standards and replace legacy Connect API with something that is web compatible as part of the Cervix project that is also powering H3. We also improved the Node.js compatibility for Edge. OnEnv is the compatible layer that we initially created for Nitro to make it possible to deploy Nitro applications on Edge. Now with the collaboration with Clover team, we have much better compatibility version 2. Using hybrid native polyfills, we can leverage both polyfills and exactly for the exports and the features that have a native implementation, we can integrate them all from both sides. This version of unenv is now directly also integrated to Cloudflare Workers, so any Wrangler deployment can enable the Node.js compatibility and leverage unenv layer. This version of unenv has full Node.js module explorer, so it's increasing the compatibility with the MPM ecosystem much more. And we are also focusing and working with Node.js team to improve the runtime support, so we actually backport and polyfill more features of Node inside your deployments. Thank you.